a true story about the last of the Red Hot Mamas, all right? Her name was Mary. Mary Burke Norton. And she was otherwise known as the Queen of the 88's. That's right. Now, when I was 10 years old, I'd been playing the piano for 7 years, but I could not read a note of music. And one day, my mama and my daddy, they said, Kelley, it's time you learn how to read some music. Might come in handy someday. They were right. They took me to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different piano teachers, and every one of those old ladies said, well, you play all right, but this playing by ear is not gonna go around here, and this boogie-woogie thing has got to go, got to go. And every time I'd go home crying. And my mom looked at my dad and she said, you know what? Something's not right. And she got an idea. She said, Kelley, come on with me and don't cry no more. 'Cause it's time to go see the Queen. So we went down to 5th and Arundel Street in Emporia, Kansas. That's right. And we pulled up to a little brown house about the size of this stage, and out walked Mary. She's about 5 feet tall, just about 5 feet wide. She had herself a bright red wig on her head, and that woman had a ring on every finger. She was waving a cigarette around in the air. She looked me up and down and put her hands on her hips, and she said, child! She said, child! She said, what do you want to do? And I said, well, I do not want to take piano lessons from you. Now, remember, I was 10 years old at the time, and she was scaring me half to death. So she said, I don't feel like teaching you any, so it's all right. I asked you what you want to do. So I put my hands on my hips and I looked right back at her and I said, well, I'll tell you what I want to do. I want to boogie boogie, that's what I want to do. And all of a sudden, everything changed. She dropped that cigarette, she took me by the hand. She said, come on, come on. Come on, come on. And we went inside of that little bitty house. And the main piece of furniture in that tiny living room, it was a chocolate brown baby grand piano. And I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. She said, I'm gonna sit down, play you a little song, and you tell me if that's what you wanna learn how to do. All right, and I said, yeah, I'm ready. Come on. And so she got a wig ready. And she got her rings ready. And she sat herself down on the piano bench. And she went like this. Looked at me. She said, is that what you want to learn how to do? And I said, yeah! I said, yeah, yeah! I said, yeah, 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 yeah! I sure do! So that's when the party started. Oh, with the Queen of the 88's. And you know what? She's not really gone now, 'cause she's in my right hand. Yes, she is. She's in this left hand too. Oh. She's right here in my heart. And tonight in Kansas City, she's gonna play with me for you. And here we go. I said, yeah. in 1933. She wasn't playing the piano in the Church of the Calvary. But when the congregation left, the preacher went home. She made sure she was all alone. That old piano just shook with a boogie-woogie beat. And it went something like this. Swinging at the Eagles Club, dancing with the girls and having great big fun. The boys jumped up, threw down their cigars, shouted, play that boogie woogie, play it. Ate to the bar and they said, Mary, Mary Burke Norton, you're the queen of the 88's. Hot dog, should have seen it. I know that you would say the same. All the stars shouting out, Mary. They said, Mary Burke, the 88's, and there will never be anybody else to take your place. I believe I'm gonna play some right now. Say the same.